Hi, I'm Susan Rutledge, and in this video, I'll show you how I made this Twill Christmas plaid seamless pattern swatch edged with a seamless pattern brush in Adobe Illustrator. That's quite a mouthful, and it's hard to say, but it's not hard to make. It just has a lot of steps, and you've got to follow them one by one. I'll move to a document where I've already selected my colors. I downloaded these from color.adobe.com, which is Adobe's free color website. And at the end of this video, I'll leave a link to a tutorial explaining how to use that website, which you may want to check out next. Now we'll start with the background of our design. I'll get the rectangle tool, keyboard shortcut M, and click on the artboard to open the rectangle dialog box. I'll type in 4 inches for the width, tab down, and type in 4 inches for the height, and say OK. Then I'll get the eyedropper tool, keyboard shortcut I, and I'm going to click on this bottom green to create the background color. Then I'll get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and click on the artboard to deselect the rectangle. And then I'm going to create 12 random width stripes on top of the background. I'll click on the top green circle to make it the active color, then get the rectangle tool, keyboard shortcut M, and I'll just drag out a rectangle, then get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and click on the artboard to deselect that. Click on the red to make it the active color. Get the rectangle tool, keyboard shortcut M, and drag out another color. And then I'll speed up the video as I continue to drag out the stripes. And as a reminder, I'll drag out a stripe, then I click on the artboard to deselect it, then click on the color I want to make that the active color, then get the rectangle tool and drag out another rectangle. And it's really a fairly fast process in and of itself. I've chosen to use 4 colors. You can use as many or as few as you want. And in addition to making them different widths, I'm also trying to make sure that they're not the same space apart from one another. So I'll use my arrow keys, and there's really not a right or a wrong way. Just get it where you want. Then I'll select the stripes in the background and get the Shape Builder tool, keyboard shortcut Shift M, and I'll hold the Option key down and drag across the pieces that extend beyond the background because we don't need those. As I drag over those, holding down the Option key, Illustrator deletes them. Then I'll get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and group these objects together, keyboard shortcut Command G. Then I'll hold down the Option key and drag to the right to create another copy. And then I'll get the Rotate tool, keyboard shortcut R, and rotate the copy. I'll hold down the Shift key so as I drag, my design snaps in 45 degree increments, and I'll stop at 90 degrees and release my mouse. Then I'll go over to the Layers panel. I'm going to twirl open the layers, and I'm going to hide the layer that I have selected, the horizontal lines, by just clicking on the little eyeball. And I'll use the vertical lines to make the diagonal twill weave. I'll move back to the Properties panel and get the Line Segment tool, keyboard shortcut backslash, and I need to measure the distance between the top left anchor and the bottom right anchor so I know how long to make my lines. And in the little gray text box next to my cursor, I see that it's 5.66 inches. Well, I'll release my mouse and delete that, and then click on the artboard to open the Line Segment tool options dialog box, and I'm going to round up to the nearest inch, which would be 6 inches, and then I'll type in 45 degrees for the angle and say OK. I'm going to add just a little bit of weight to the stroke so I can see it. Then I'll get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and place my cursor on the center of the stroke, drag it over, and place that center on the top left anchor of the background. I see the word intersect. That's from my smart guides being turned on. If you're not seeing intersect, then you'll need to go up to View, down to Smart Guides, turn them on here, or use the keyboard shortcut Command U. Then I'll place my cursor on the center of the stroke again. I'll hold down the Option key to make a copy and the Shift key so I drag in a 45 degree line. And when I see intersect down here with the bottom right anchor, I'll release my mouse. Now I'll hold down the Shift key to reselect the top line, and I'm going to change the stroke weight to 5 points. And let's change the color to black. Then I'll go up to Object, down to Path, and change these to Outline Strokes. So now these are both really, really long rectangles. They're objects instead of strokes. Next, I'll use the Blend tool to create copies of these lines and evenly space them in between the top and the bottom. I'll go up to Object, down to Blend, and choose Blend Options. Now I'm going to change the spacing from Smooth Color to Specified Steps. And the default setting is for 8 steps. Now I know I need a lot more than that, but I really need to eyeball it. And the preview is grayed out, so I'm not going to be able to see what it looks like. So I'm going to cancel this and show you a trick with the Blend Options that allows you to preview those lines before you actually make the blend. I'll go up to Object, down to Blend, and I'm just going to click Make. And Illustrator puts one line in between the top and the bottom. And now, when I go up to Object, Blend, Blend Options, Preview is no longer grayed out. So I come over here and choose Specified Steps, and I'm just going to scroll with my mouse, and I want to get these lines really close together. Let's see. That may be good there. I need to make sure that my number is uneven. I'm going to go ahead and say OK. And then I've got to go back up one more time. Object, Blend, and this time Expand. And now each one of the lines is a separate object, and I'm going to have to ungroup those. Keyboard shortcut Shift Command G. Then I'll select the lines and the background design, go over to the Properties panel, and in the Pathfinder area, I'm going to click on the ellipsis to open up more options. And under Pathfinders, I'll click on this first icon. This is Divide, and then select everything one more time and ungroup it. Keyboard shortcut Shift Command G. Then the last step is to click on one of these lines, go up to Select, Same Fill Color, and press the Delete key. Now this part of the design is finished. I'll select it all and group it, keyboard shortcut Command G, and go back to the Layers panel and unhide our horizontal lines and select both of these. Go to the Properties panel, click on Horizontal Align Center and Vertical Align Center, and we're ready for the reveal. I'll click on the artboard to deselect the design, and here it is. And it has turned out really great, but we're not finished. So I'll select all of the design. I'm going to group it, keyboard shortcut Command G, and we're going to begin working on the pattern brush. I'll get the Line Segment tool, keyboard shortcut backslash, and click on the artboard to open the dialog box. I'll be using a length of 1 inch, and I have the angle set to 90 degrees, and I'll say OK. Then I'll change the color of the stroke to black and increase the weight to 4 points. Next, I'll get the Ellipse tool, keyboard shortcut L, click on the artboard to open the ellipse dialog box. And for both the width and the height setting, I'm going to use 0.1 inch and say OK. Then I'll fill the circle with black. Get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V. Then I'm going to move the circle and place the center of it on the bottom anchor of my stroke. And when I see intersect, I'll release my mouse. Then I'll select the stroke and the circle, go up to Object, and click on Expand. I'm going to expand both the fill and the stroke, so I'll say OK. Then move to the Properties panel, and in the Pathfinder area, I'll click to Unite. So now this is one solid piece. Now with this piece selected, I'll go up to Object, Transform, Move. I'll type in 0.2 inches for the horizontal position, tab down and type 0 for the vertical position, and press Copy. Then I'll duplicate that move with the keyboard shortcut Command D. Now I'll apply some of our colors here. I'll get the eyedropper tool, keyboard shortcut I, and apply red. Get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, select another stroke. Get the eyedropper tool. We'll do light green here. Get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, select this one. Get the eyedropper tool and click on the dark green here. Get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and now we're going to rotate a couple of these. I'll get the rotate tool, keyboard shortcut R, and hover over the bottom center anchor. Hold down the Option key and then click down with my mouse. That opens the rotate dialog box, and I'm going to type in -2 degrees and say OK. Then get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and select the center stroke. Get the rotate tool, keyboard shortcut R. Hover over that bottom anchor, hold down the Option key, and click down with the mouse. And for this angle, we're going to type in 2 and say OK. Then I'll get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and select the strokes and group them, keyboard shortcut Command G. Now select the group. I'm going to hold down the Option key and drag to the right, holding down the Shift key so I stay in the same horizontal line. And when it looks like the spacing between the two groups is about the same as the spacing between each of the individual strokes, I'll release my mouse. Then I'll select the original group again, hold down the Option key and drag down and hold the Shift key down so I drag in the same vertical line. And when the edges of the two groups intersect, I'll release my mouse, click on the artboard to deselect the strokes. And this gives me a guide so I know the size and the placement I need for my bounding box. Well, what's a bounding box? The bounding box is what tells Illustrator exactly how to place the design in the pattern brush so it does what you want it to do. I'm going to show you what would happen with this specific design if I didn't use a bounding box. I'll go up to Window, down to Brushes, and grab the Brushes tab and drag and dock it next to the Layers tab. Now I've already created a pattern brush out of just the design without a bounding box. I want you to see what happens. I'll get the Rectangle tool, keyboard shortcut M. I'll drag out a rectangle and get the eyedropper tool, keyboard shortcut I, and change that to white. And I'll apply the pattern brush and show you the problem. Without a bounding box around the design, by default, Illustrator places the center of the design and not the base of the design around the outside edge of whatever object you apply the pattern brush to. And in some cases, that's not a problem. In this case, it would put half of our fringe on top of our plaid, and I don't want that. The other issue is Illustrator doesn't add space in between the pattern repeats, which means I don't have any space between each of my groupings of three strokes. So my bounding box is going to have to do two things. It's got to give me a little space between the repeats, and it's got to tell Illustrator I want the base of my design and not the center of it to go along the outside edge of the object. Now the bounding box has got to be invisible, so the first thing I'll do is click on the artboard to deselect this rectangle, and then I'll get the rectangle tool, keyboard shortcut M. I'll move over to the properties panel. I'm going to remove the white fill and the white stroke. I'll start in the top left corner of the design. Smart Guides tells me when I'm lined up perfectly on the left side. I'll click down with my mouse and drag down into the right. I'll go all the way down and intersect with the bottom of the lower set of strokes and over to the right until I intersect with the group on the right. Then I'll release my mouse. So what this bounding box will do is provide the exact space between the pattern repeats, and then because it is double the height of the design, when Illustrator places the center of the bounding box on the outside edge of the plaid, it's actually going to be placing the base of my design along the plaid. So now all I have to do is get rid of the extra strokes. I'll get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, select this group and delete them, and select this group and delete them. Now I have my strokes and my invisible bounding box. But the bounding box has got to be in the layer behind the design, so I'm going to select it and move it to the back layer using the keyboard shortcut Shift Command Left Bracket. Now I'll select the strokes and the bounding box and group them, keyboard shortcut Command G. And one last thing, I'm going to reduce the design before I put it in the brushes panel. So I'll go up to Object, Transform, Scale, and we're going to use a 50% uniform scale, and I'll say OK. Then I'll go to the brushes panel, And down at the bottom bar, I'll click on the new brush icon and I'll click pattern brush and say OK. I'm going to name this fringe and then go to this left bin, which is the outer corner bin, and I'll click on the pull down menu and I'm going to use the auto between option here and say OK. Now I'll click on the rectangle and I want to try out this new pattern brush. I'll click here. And that looks exactly like what I wanted. The design is placed right along the outside edge and the spacing between the repeats is perfect. So I can delete this rectangle. I need to get the swatches panel. I'll go up to window, down to swatches, and grab the tab and drag and dock it next to the brushes panel. Then we'll select our design and drag and drop it into the swatches panel. Now, if you have color groups like I do, be sure and drag your swatch up above those color groups. And then I'll move up to the layers panel and I'll hide the layers and create a new layer for our final design. And get the rectangle tool, keyboard shortcut M, and drag out a rectangle. Then I'll move to the swatches panel and first apply our swatch. And then go to the brushes panel and apply our pattern brush. And I'll click on the artboard to deselect everything. And here's our final project. And I gotta say, this is my favorite seamless pattern swatch yet. I love the colors and I love the design. And I think that fringe is the perfect final touch. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video as much as I enjoyed making it, and I want to invite you now to subscribe to my channel and click the notification bell so that you don't miss any of my future tutorials, and I'll look forward to seeing you again next time. Thank you so much for watching. Bye now.